Welcome back. This is the Shaka Smart Radio Show. Coach Smart out recruiting. Mike Rhodes, assistant coach here. Mike, I'm going to let you introduce one of our special guests here with us tonight at the Shaka Smart Radio Show at Home Team Grill.
Do I have to do it like the PA announcer?
Oh, you could if you want.
I have it down. Javonte Redick is a 6'9 junior from Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And out of all the guys in our program, this guy has taken huge steps as a person, as a young man, as a basketball player. And he has such a bright future, and we're really, really happy he's in part of our family, that's for sure.
How about a big round of applause for Javonte Redick? There's that big smile, Jew. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good. Thank you.
Talk about, you're the reigning A-10 player of the week. You've been on a great stretch, four straight double-doubles. You feel like you've been in a little bit of a zone here these last four or five games?
Yeah, most definitely. It's a great feeling, you know, to win, to have such a great accomplishment. And, you know, I'm looking forward to having a lot more. And I couldn't have done it without, you know, my teammates and my coaching staff putting, you know, giving me the confidence I have to, you know, go out there and play my best.
You don't have to, you know, sing our praises. You're playing 38 minutes a game anyway. so relax. The one thing we talk to Drew all the time is trying to do more because he has that ability and he keeps doing it all the time. And he really does a good job of taking what the coaches tell him and add it to his game and add it to the game we're in at that time and to his individual game. And I keep talking about he's going to get a 20 rebound game one of these days.
Well, that's not easy to do in this league, right? No. I mean, have you noticed, the A-10, we know it's a better league. Have you kind of noticed that, Jew?
Oh, yes, I've noticed it. It's definitely a bigger league, you know, better competition. Teams, they're aggressive. Any team can be beat in the league. You know, every team is good, so you just got to come out and play your best every night. There's no night like you can take off. You got to play your best at all times.
Yeah. Talk a little bit about the way this team's played. You had those two losses, and it seemed after that, you know, it was a little bit of a kick in the butt, and it seems like you guys have been dialed in at least these last couple of games.
Yeah, we lost two in a row. You know, of course, the Richmond game, that was a very hard one. You know, I thought we had that game, but, you know, it just comes down to, you know, following the plan at the end of the game. But this is one of the things we got to let go. We got to let go. Coach Smart, he's big on, you know, letting – things go in the past and moving on and looking forward to the next game. And I think we've done a good job, you know, getting over those two losses and bouncing back with the win. And it's just one of those things, you know, we can't control. Coach Smart is big on, you know, on us focusing on the things we can control rather than the things we cannot control. I think we've done a good job doing that.
Coach, can you talk about the mental aspect of the game? It's something you guys talk about a lot. And I know Javonte's been working on that.
All the time. And you know, we always talk to our guys about being in the moment, being in the present. You can't change the past. You can't worry about the future because we're not there yet. And Javonte leads our group with Darius and Troy of getting our team ready to play and be in the moment. And Coach, I mean, I think that's one of Shaka's greatest strengths is the mental part of it and having our guys prepared for what we need to do at that specific time. And I think this team has done a good job. You hear Javonte say, follow the plan. That's a big phrase we have in our program is if you follow the plan, good things are going to happen. And sometimes you steer off the plan, and that happened a little bit for us. We got to get back on it, and our guys do a good job of it. You know, one thing, you know, we always talk about is if you have good kids in your program, they're not perfect. You don't want them to be perfect because there's no growth then. Our guys are growing. We're getting better. And I think this time of the year is where I think that stuff can carry over to some great wins and getting hot at the right time. And guys like Javonte have really bought into that. And I think following the plan that Coach talks about has been pretty good for us so far.
Yeah, Javonte, do you feel like, you know, as far as the mental plan, you know, you're starting to figure out that, hey, I can let that last play go. If it didn't go exactly the way you wanted it to go, you can let it go and focus on the next possession.
Yes. I think I've done it. I'm doing a good job. You know, it's one of those things I'm still working on. Sometimes if I make a mistake, I sometimes, you know, think about that mistake a lot instead of moving on to the next. But I think I've done a very good job in, you know, moving on and not thinking about the mistake I did or, you know, if I turn the ball over and just move on to the next play. And I think that's played a big part in the way I've been playing in the last few games.
I know that you guys are headed down to Charlotte, kind of your neck of the woods. Are you excited about this one?
I'm very excited. Some of my family get to come out and see me play for the first time that don't get to travel to Virginia, so it's going to be great.
This is a big one. We talked about it, but it's always special when a guy gets to play close to home.
Absolutely, and have some familiar faces in the crowd, and I'm sure they'll have some Javonte Redick jerseys on and a lot of black and gold. But you're exactly right. You go into people's backyards and you see some familiar faces and they cheer. And I know we'll have a great fan base down there. I know a lot of people will travel down there. I'm sure they've done it in the past as well. And VCU is well represented wherever we go.
Javonte, who's the most competitive coach on the staff?
Most competitive?
Yeah, who's the most competitive? We've heard these legendary stories about how the staff is really competitive. Who do you think's the most competitive?
I have to say the man right here sitting down next to me.
This guy?
Yeah, he's definitely the most competitive. You know, sometimes he plays with us in segments in practice, and he's always going after our players. You know, of course it's getting them better, but you know he's such a great player. Like back then when he played in college, so it shows when he's going against us, and it's kind of funny because he's like. Even though he's, old. I'm gonna say old.
Yeah, it was right there. You're about to say it, right?
He still plays like he's like the same age as us.
He gets after
yes.
it.
Yes, he's a great shooter too. You can't leave him open at all.
Wait a second. Your boy Buzz is over there. Are you sure you want to say that? That Coach is a great shooter?
I don't know. They both great shooters, but I think Coach could get them.
I don't know.
What were you thinking?
You hear that, Troy?
Honestly, they're gonna.
Number one thing is confidence, right? Confidence.
I have a feeling we're going to roll a hoop out in the street here, and we're going to have a shooting contest before the night's over between Buzz and Coach here.
Sorry, Buzz.
Javonte, what were you thinking the day when Coach lost a tooth on the court?
Oh, wait, that's two.
Two tooth.
Yeah.
Two teeth.
I was speechless. It just happened so fast. I was like, his teeth really get knocked out? And then I looked on the floor. It's like they're both just on the floor scattered. I was like, oh, wow. So, you know, I was in shock. I didn't really think it
and
happened.
And didn't miss a beat.
Yeah.
Right? Kept playing.
He kept playing. He's a tough guy.
That's amazing.
It's not one of my prouder moments, that's for sure.
But
the guy that got sick the most out of it was Troy. He had to walk out of the gym.
I'll have to ask him about that.
To the dentist, but Troy was done for a while.
So, Troy, we'll have to ask him about that. What's your favorite thing about being part of the VCU family? Not just the basketball family, but the VCU family, Javonte.
I would have to say the amount of love we get between each other. You know, everybody cares about each other, and is always there when somebody's down. Somebody's always there to lift them up. So I have to say, you know, everybody's been there for each other. And I know everybody's been there for me, and I appreciate everything.
Yeah, that's something you guys preach. I mean,
all the time.
But it doesn't always take, right, Coach? You try to preach that, but you need the guys to buy in and really be.
Yeah, and if you recruit good kids, when they come here and they see this, they instead of them fighting it, they want to say, "I want to be a part of this." And you know, Javonte knows when he got here, we had his back, and we were going to hold him to a high standard, but we had his back. And now, what's great is he's telling the young guys, "No, this is how we do it here." And we got your back, and it's a family. You hear that term on teams sometimes, but I think people see it, and we live it every day. And I think the greatest strength of our program is the quality time that the coaches and the players spend together away from the game. And I think when 20 years from now, he's going to come back here, not because he scored a lot of points at VCU, but because of the relationships he has. And that's sort of when it comes down to it, you can throw the ball away. That's what it's all about. And that's the type of life you want to live. And he gets to do it now, and he's one of our leaders. So that's fun. That's exciting.
Well said. How about a big round of applause for Javonte Redick? Great job, Jew. Well done.